Lord, make me an instrument of thy peace. Where there is hatred, let us sow love. Where there is doubt, let us sow faith. Where there is despair, let us sow hope. Where there is sadness, let us sow joy. And where there is darkness, let us sow light. The whole sentiment behind this was trying to remove whatever you think the music should sound like, whatever you think you should play like, whatever you think that you should bring, whatever it is, just put that aside and just be honest in the moment. Surrender is a huge word in this whole process of making this record, because I think to have the certain conviction, you have to surrender to what the moment is, and you have to say, you know, world, this is who I am. You have to open yourself up. You have to be vulnerable to do that. That's what the conviction is about. The conviction is saying that it's okay to be vulnerable for me, and it's okay to be who I am and not who I want to be. That was the main sentiment behind the music and how it was created. The greatest thing in the world is to play with artists that you respect. And all of these guys, I respect to the utmost. I respect them as human beings first. And then as artists and as musicians, I respect them so much.
If I was a different man, if I had blood in my eyes.
I kind of feel like, you know, I'm working with the young lions of the jazz industry, you know? Like, these are the up-and-coming guys, like, they're fairly young, and I think as they get older, we're going to hear a lot more about these guys. They're very talented, all of them, so I kind of feel like there's something special.
This is Kendrick pushing himself conceptually and as a writer. There's a lot of, you know, genres kind of crossing paths and meeting on this record, which I think is a beautiful thing. It's a nice blend of a lot of different backgrounds, you know, but it's very forward thinking.
This is the music of the time. That's the best way I can explain it. It's what's going on right now in this area. It's not like what happened last week or what's gonna happen in the future. I think that's what's great about everybody here, is that they embody that. You know, it's never maybe I want to play this here, maybe I want to play that. We just play it and see what happens. But the emotion is always there. The sincerity is always there.
Derek and Kendrick have such a vision for this record, but then at the same time, it's still a very collaborative process in terms of how we're doing the arrangements and, you know, taking sections out, putting sections in, layering things. It feels like everyone's voice is heard, and I think it definitely shows in the music.
I want people to know when they hear this record that they're hearing every honest aspect of Kendrick Scott, not Kendrick trying to prove a point as a drummer or get all of his favorite guys that can play the most chops. He's not trying to prove anything. This is honest Kendrick, for better or for worse. He's taking risks that I can honestly say I haven't heard him take as far as his recorded product, you know, but I feel like this is where he is, and I feel like this hopefully will come across as a great representation of him. The stuff you hear, the arrangements, the even the singer-songwriter stuff, he wrote this music. It's him, so you either love it or you don't.
This is a beautiful, honest record of Kendrick. I think he's really striving to think long and hard about the music that he cares about and the music that he identifies with, and to include that into whatever he's doing. This is music made by the highest level jazz musicians who are also very open to lots of other types of music. So I think it puts it a little bit in a beyond category place. I would say this record might be difficult to categorize, but that's one of the things I think that's great about it.
But it's funny how, you know, when Kendrick describes, you know, he feels like this is the most vulnerable part of his life. Ironically, this is a time where I felt like he's been playing with such a passion and a confidence in himself, where I could feel his experiences, you know what I mean? That comes with him being strong enough to let go and be willing to expose that. So I hope when people get it, they'll just know that it's something honest. You know what I mean? I don't care what they call it. Call it jazz if you want, call it whatever. I don't care what you call it. You know what I mean? That's a debate for other people. I just hope, you know, they realize it's heartfelt music, you know, like I felt when I first heard it, so. I think this record is hopefully gonna be just the next level of where I wanna go in my life. Just, I wanna keep building, constantly building, and I just think this will be another step. I think it's the best step that I can take at this moment, and the most honest portrayal of who I am at this moment and time. And I think that's what making a record should be, the honest portrayal of who you are in one moment, and not necessarily anything that you would try to project anything, you know what I mean? I'm just pretty much stating the facts of who I am. And that's what conviction is about. That's what the whole record is about.